السلام عليكم. بسم الله نبدأ مناقشة assessment of fetal well-being in pregnancy. First, which factors influence women's perception of this activity? First of all, fetal sleep cycle. The fetus passes into times in which it sleeps, so no activity during this time for about 20 to 40 minutes, and sometimes it reaches 90 minutes. Maternal position, if the woman is lying down, she will feel the fetal movement much more better than if she is sitting, and again it is better than if she is standing. So busy woman may not perceive fetal movement during the time of fetal activity. Drugs may reduce the fetal movement, and the smoking again will reduce fetal movement. Maternal blood glucose. Raised blood glucose will increase the fetal movement, so that after meals the woman will perceive fetal movement more than other times. Administration of corticosteroids. This will reduce the fetal movements and will reduce the variability for 2 days after the corticosteroids intake. Fetal malformation. Certain malformations reduce the fetal movement, and the position of the fetal back anterior, the perception of fetal movement will be less. How we can assess the fetal movement? First, subjective معناها the patient feels fetal movement. Okay, the mother told you that I have reduced fetal movement less than before. Objective assessment means we use an object, for example an ultrasound, so that we can observe the fetal movement. Management of women with reduced fetal movement. First of all, by history we look for risk factors. For example, if there is any risk factor for fetal growth restriction or intrauterine fetal death, if the mother is hypertensive, diabetic, if she is postterm, if she has a bad obstetric history, for example a prior fetal death, these should be taken into consideration. Next, kick count. Reassuring if 4 or more movements felt in 1 hour. We ask the mother to lie down and count the fetal movement in 1 hour. If it is 4 and more, this is reassuring. 3 or less indicate further assessment. And another approach is to ask the mother to count fetal movement when she wake up and record the number of hours required for feeling of 10 movements. If it takes 2 to 3 hours, by examination, the key point when a woman present with reduced fetal movement is to confirm fetal viability. First of all, we use a Doppler device so that we can confirm that the fetus is alive. Because if the fetus is dead, one of the presentation is absent fetal movement. Then general examination, body mass index and general health, general look of the mother, vital signs, the important thing is the blood pressure. Abdominal examination, we measure the symphysio-fundal height to detect the small for gestational age fetuses. Put in mind that we have assessment of fetal well-being, which means the health of the fetus, and assessment of fetal growth, that is to say the growth of the fetus according to gestational age. Next, if the woman has reduced fetal movement, we will do a non-stress test in which we measure the fetal heart at least 2 or more accelerations with fetal movement in a 20 minute by at least 15 beats per minute for 15 seconds. This is considered as reactive non-stress test. Before 32 weeks, accelerations are defined as having an acceleration 10 beats per minute and non-15. معناها إذا الفيتس قبل 32 أسبوع يعني preterm نعتمد على 10 beats per minute. Okay, above the baseline. يعني مثلا إذا البيزلان هو 150 لازم يوصل إلى 160. for 10 seconds or longer. Reactive NST is highly predictive of low risk of fetal mortality in the subsequent 72 to 96 hours. يعني إذا الـ NST طلع reactive أقول هذا الفيتس is healthy 3 إلى 4 أيام. Okay. And again it is predictive at 1 week. After 32 weeks a non-reactive tracing. يعني ما صار عندي accelerations within 20 minutes. Further prompt evaluation fetal wellbeing should measure the biophysical profile. فهسه احنا نخط ultrasound by which we measure the biophysical profile. When we do ultrasound, ultrasound is performed for a woman with reduced fetal movement after 28 weeks if the perception of reduced fetal movement persists despite normal CTG. يعني سويت لها NST طلع NST reactive and I reassure the patient. Then she presents to me again telling me that she has reduced fetal movement. If there is additional risk factor for fetal growth restriction or stillbirth, for example, she has hypertension in this pregnancy or early pregnancy bleeding or antepartum hemorrhage, this is additional risk factor, so we should do ultrasound. The idea from ultrasound first is to measure the fetal biometry, قياسات الطفل. We measure the abdominal circumference, estimated fetal weight. على مود نميز هذا الطفل is normally grown or it is a growth restricted. And the assessment of amniotic fluid. Put in mind that amniotic fluid volume will be reduced in cases of fetal growth restriction. يعني إذا نمو الطفل مو طبيعي حيصير vasoconstriction in the descending aorta to maintain the blood supply to the heart, brain and adrenal. So the kidney will be affected and the urine output will be reduced. لذلك الأمنيوتيك fluid will be reduced. Again, assessment of fetal morphology because abnormal babies may present with reduced fetal movement. So, fetal biometry, amniotic fluid volume and fetal morphology. By ultrasound, we will measure the biophysical profile. This profile has a total score of 10 and it should be in even numbers, not odd numbers, يعني أرقام زوجية. The first parameter is the non-stress test. If it is reactive, I will give the fetus 2 scores. If it is non-reactive, 0 score. You see we extend the measurements for 40 minutes to overcome the fetal sleep cycle. Fetal breathing movement more than or equal to 30 seconds in 30 minutes, less than 30 seconds in 30 minutes. The fetal body movements, 3 or more gross body movements in 30 minutes, 2 or fewer means 0 score. The fetal tone, the difference of tone from a gross body movement is that it is a coordinated movement of muscle. For example, one episode of limb flexion followed by extension. مثلا elbow joint يسوي لي extension بعدين flexion. معناها the tone of the muscles are appropriate. Or open, close cycle of the hand. يفتح ايده ويسدها. هذا معناه tone. Okay. If no such coordinated movement will give 0 scores. Amniotic fluid volume, the largest cord-free pocket over 1 cm. أدور على أكبر pocket of amniotic fluid. It should be more than 1 cm, less than 1 cm. Pocket we give 0. A score of 6 raises concern and the biophysical profile should be repeated in 6 to 24 hours. Especially in fetuses over 32 weeks. If the score does not improve, delivery should be considered depending on gestational age and individual circumstances. The score of 4 or below are worrisome and delivery should be considered depending on gestational age and the clinical context. يعني 8-10 normal, 6 and below, this is a possibly abnormal and indicate further assessment. Non-stress test and amniotic fluid index, this is the modified biophysical profile. بدل ما نقضي وقت طويل نقيس ال breathing movement والtone والgross body movement, only these two parameters will be enough. Okay, the amniotic fluid index is measured by the sum, مجموع, the maximum vertical pockets of umbilical cord free amniotic fluid in each of the four quadrants of the uterus. See here, this is the amniotic fluid index. We divide imaginarily the uterus into four quadrants, okay, and we measure where is pocket with no free fetal parts. You see, this is pocket, the vertical depth, this is pocket. Here you see this is a free fetal parts pockets, okay, just amniotic fluid. تشوفون هاي الاريا السوداء هاي معناها ماكو fetal parts, هاي اجزاء الطفل. نقيس ال vertical depth in four quadrants A, B, C and D, and this will give us indication about the amniotic fluid index. Normally it is between 8 to 25 cm, less than 5 oligohydramnios, more than 25 polyhydramnios. Next, by ultrasound is the Doppler study. You see this is the normal diastolic flow. Normally the blood flows to the fetus during systole and during diastole. Okay, so there should be diastolic flow to the fetus even during diastole. Here, this is abnormality which is reduced and diastolic flow. You see, this is very small amount of blood reaching the fetus during diastole. And here, reversed diastolic flow. This is abnormal, which means that the resistance in the placenta is so high that reducing the blood towards the mother during maternal diastole. This is abnormal umbilical artery Doppler. You see this is absent end diastolic flow, and here reverse end diastolic flow. Whereas the middle cerebral artery normally it has a high resistance to protect the brain from the excessive blood waves. Whereas if there is abnormal fetus, I mean fetal growth restriction, there will be vasodilatation in the brain vessels, so there will be increased diastolic flow. لذلك لازم نميز انه الميدل سيربرال ارتري يختلف عن الامبلايكال ارتري. الميدل سيربرال ارتري تقل المقاومة مالته مع حدوث مشكلة في نمو الجنين. This is the middle cerebral artery. You see it is a high resistance, okay, whereas the umbilical artery the resistance is lower. If there is any abnormality, the middle cerebral artery the blood flow will be increased, whereas the umbilical artery the blood flow will be reduced or absent, which indicate fetal acidemia. Finally, we have the contraction stress test. Here we induce labor by putting oxytocin, and if there are late decelerations in more than 50% of contraction, this indicates contraction stress test positive, and that fetus is possibly hypoxic and cannot withstand a normal labor. The disadvantage is that it is an invasive test and not suitable for preterm fetuses because it may stimulate labor. Thank you so much.